Today it's Arsenal against West Bromwich Albion. Let's go straight to the Emirates Stadium, the home of Arsenal. A marvellous, clear day in North London.
James Morrison. Manutd. Well, he tried his luck from a long way out, but the goalkeeper had no problems at all. Santi Cazorla. Aaron Ramsey. And that's good support as they build this attack. Francis Coquelin. Ledger. Francis Coquelin. There's the ball in. Giroud in the middle. And he reached it, he has, with a diving header to score. Fabulous.
A goal from Giroud. I wondered if the keeper should have done a little bit better with that header, you know.
Good look here, again, by the replay of the goal. And it's Arsenal who hold the advantage as the second half is underway. Slipped his man. What a chance here. Got to be. Excellent work from the keeper.
Well, all about agility and reactions. He's got both in abundance.
Shot. Oh, he said it very true, just off target. And now he's looking for some support.
Oh, he's through.
Oh, what a cheeky attempt.
He saved it.
Well, the back four was beaten, but that goalkeeper wasn't.
Theo Walcott. Well, he saw the guy he could switch the play to and came up with the pass as well. Excellent.
Pointed straight to the spot. Penalty given.
Well, it's a penalty, and the referee's added to their problems.
Yeah, lost the composure, haven't they? It's been a poor day, and it's only going to get worse here.
Bench for the losing team. A substitute getting ready to come on. Final whistle.
Ladies and gentlemen, I hope you've enjoyed your day here. Have a safe
really
day.
Good game to watch. Good attacking play. Edge of the seat stuff for the spectators. It's what the game's all about.
Yeah, and there's nothing better, Martin, than seeing quality strikers go about the work. And we certainly did today. They were at the top of the game.
So it's full time with a final score 2-0. Today it's Aston Villa against Burnley. Let's go straight off to Villa Park then. Conditions could hardly be better, certainly for spectators at least. Clear blue skies and warm sunshine.
Westwood. Fabian Delph. Benteke. And Villa could be in here, in with a chance. Super goalkeeping. Leandro Bacuna. Benteke. An opening for Aston Villa. He's got space. Here's the chance. They score.
He just shaped his body there beautifully to stroke it into the bottom left.
cleverly. Benteke. This could be it. Not to me. There's still a chance after the save. And now they've got a corner on the attack again, the team. In it, goal. Here's the chance. Goal. Aston Villa have scored.
And well, that's evaded the keeper's grasp. A really good finish from him.
And Jones. Here he is with a chance. Got to be. And the goalkeeper has done well to stop that one. Club got to be. Aston Villa have got the goal here. As for Aston Villa, that should really wrap it up. They played well today, and the latest goal confirms their victory, you would think.
You don't always get what you deserve, but I think Villa have here.
Benteke. This is the chance. Here's the shot. The goal stands.
And that's blown past the keeper before, really, he could react.
It away. Well, no contest in the end. A comprehensive win by four goals to nil.
Well, one team's coming off looking pretty fresh, the other team exhausted. They've been chasing the game, haven't they, the whole time?
Yeah, they have, and a game they haven't enjoyed, and they just want to hear the final whistle.
It's Crystal Palace against Swansea City. So let's head straight off to Selhurst Park right now. Glorious day in South London, couldn't be better. Clear blue skies.
I think that's the one less encouraging aspect of money coming into the game, and that young players get too much too soon. And as I say, it can take away a little bit of the edge from them. I'd like to see it more performance-based.
What a chance here, got to be. Oh, that's a great goal and a great start.
The keeper's got no chance because he's hit it so hard to his right.
Nelson Oliveira. Jefferson Montero. This is a very good individual. Now they... That is a free kick. And they've got a chance to really make the most of that decision. Keep it out.
Well, he's just got the power in it, hasn't he? And I think that's what has beaten the keeper there.
Shut out, it's still in play. And he's met it with his head. And there is some backup for him in this position. And in goes the cross. That's what defenders do, head the ball away like that. Cork. Taylor. And he's in there with a header. And the header is into the net. He's doubled his money here with two great goals.
Well, I think all good teams are ruthless, Martin. And this team have been exactly that there. They wouldn't let up. Rubbing salt in the wounds.
Didn't hesitate, did he, with that challenge? And he goes for the chip. Splendid goal here.
A fantastic little dink over the keeper. It takes a cool head to execute that.
It is too far to...
And the referee brings it to a halt.
Ladies and gentlemen, I hope you've enjoyed your day here.
Well, this has been a real attacking masterclass.
Yeah, I mean, goals win football matches, and there are plenty of players capable of getting them in this team.
So it's full-time with the final score 3-1. Today it's Everton against Tottenham Hotspur. Let's get straight to Merseyside and Goodison Park then, where I'm delighted to say it's a lovely clear day and the sun is shining.
It's good balance to avoid the sliding challenge. We'll get it back here. Ross Barkley.
And he goes for goal. Kane. Close range chance, got to be. It's not a decisive save. Oh, that's a penalty. There's a penalty and a yellow card.
Yeah, and I think that's sensible. You hate to see a red card for that kind of infringement. Whether he's lost his composure, but in the end it's flown into the top left.
How frustrating is this for the other team, trying to get the touch of the ball? Tottenham, chance for them, got to be. They've still got an opportunity here after the goalkeeper parried it.
Tottenham Hotspur to start the second half, leading at this point.
Still in play here.
Two changes and one go for the manager.
Shots on here. Well, that was the shot, not a bad effort.
No, not bad.
Lamella, and that's a goal for Tottenham.
Goal from Lamella, and it's come off the forehead really solidly. Keeper no chance with that one.
Coming up another look at it, Alan, that will show us something. Ross Barkley. James McCarthy. Baines.
Here's the shot. He's failed to hit the target.
Eric Lamella. He's really strutting his stuff now.
Here's the chance.
Oh, kept the shot out. It's still in play. Here, and he goes for goal with his head.
Tottenham has scored. Spurs have scored here.
Well, the keeper, quite rightly, is disgusted with his defenders because they've just not helped him out there.
Kevin Morales. final whistle.
Well, we've seen a game here, Alan, where one team has had the ball and the other team hasn't.
Yeah, there was a golfing class out there today, which was surprising given the two sets of players. I wasn't expecting it.
So it's full time and the final score 3-0. It's Hull City against Manchester United. Let's go straight across to the Kingston Communications Stadium. Marvellous day, perfect for football with clear blue skies.
And Herrera. Mata! And it's in the net for the goal!
And here's the goal again. Ashley Young.
And Herrera.
And the cross coming in. And that cross is won by the defender.
Harris on the ball.
That's United's free kick. Past the wall, past the keeper, and into the net. Great free kick.
One thing in his mind here, and that was to hit this and hit it hard. And he did it beautifully.
Alan, have another look at this goal. Fellaini. Shaw. And in goes the cross. That's another painful moment there, physically and emotionally as well, because it was a chance. Looking for Mata. Here's the chance. Well, that was the hat-trick chance. Shaw.
Carrick on the ball.
This is the chance, got to be. And the chip, it's in! Fantastic! And it's another goal for him. He has scored with every shot he's put on target today.
Yeah, these kind of matches don't come around too often, but he's having a field day out there.
Another angle on it here. And he takes the shot. Here's the shot, and it's just wide of the target. Undoya. That's a very crisp challenge there. David Myler. Put the ball in. It's a goal!
Distance out, he had it all to do and he got the power, certainly the accuracy.
Let's see the replay now. Here's Van Persie, he's hurdled the slide tackle very well. Here he is with a chance, he's put that into his own net.
Well, it comes with the territory, doesn't it, when you're in that kind of position.
That's a goal well worth analysing again. Well, that's the end of the contest. One team's coming off looking pretty fresh, the other team exhausted. They've been chasing the game, haven't they, the whole time?
Yeah, they have, and a game they haven't enjoyed, and they'll just want to hear the final whistle.
Well, there was really only one team in that game, and their fans will be travelling home delighted with their big victory. It's Leicester City against Queen's Park Rangers. So without further ado, we take you to Leicester.
This could be a chance. And he goes for the chip.
Goalkeeper able to reach up and deal with that.
Now James. It's a chance.
Got to be.
Off the post. And he takes the shot. That's the keeper's athleticism there to make that save. Great tackling technique. Win the ball cleanly. It could be in. In with a chance. And the ball's in. It's a goal.
And if you miss that, you look a little bit foolish, but it's kind of the bottom left with a plump.
And Phillips. Good challenge here. Oh, he's through. Oh, what a cheeky attempt. He went to try and loop the ball over the goalkeeper with the lob, but it didn't quite come off for him.
Austin.
And it's a penalty.
Just a case of mistiming the tackle.
He just didn't seem to get his balance right there. It was a clumsy challenge.
Good penalty.
He really did stroke that hug to the keeper's left, giving him no chance.
That's the man, Cambiasso. Brilliant opening. Here's the chance. It's not a decisive save.
And that will clear the danger.
Here's the shot.
Before really he could react.
Mark Albright. Now James. Here's the volley.
Left-hand corner.
The goals keep on coming. It's finished now at 3-1. Well, Alan, that game has just raced by, really, because we've watched so much attacking quality here. Can't take your eyes off it.
No, there were several really talented strikers out there, and not always do they fill the bill in, but they did, and some fantastic finishes.
Today it's Manchester City against Southampton. Let's head straight for the Etihad then. Fantastic conditions for football, not a cloud in the sky.
Well, he's lent the ball to his mates, he's got it back again.
In with a chance.
A surprise for him, Alan. He's normally ruthless in front of goal.
He is only human, I suppose. It was a mistimed shot, and in the end, he can afford to laugh at it.
Giving friend has seen something that he doesn't particularly like. And no sooner the foul given than the referee says, play on, take the free kick. Dunlap.
This is the chance. Got to be.
He's done it again.
Well, he's in that kind of form at the moment. When he's in front of goal, you do not expect him to miss the goal from Aguero. And what a finish. Hit with real pace into that bottom left.
And the ball broke free. Navas Gonzalez. Nasri. Oh, he's through. He tried to chip the keeper. An offside call just at the moment where they thought they were going to be in to score. Pablo Zabaleta. Fernando.
He could be in.
Here's a chance from winning the ball.
Got to be.
Typical of him, he's got two now.
Well, goals are his trade, and he's such an accomplished finisher. A goal from Aguero. He knows about that for composure. He's dropping his shoulder, rolling it into the bottom left.
Very good passes. Now he's on a yellow card already. What about this challenge? Knowing, Alan, that he was on a yellow, why do that? He's got to go.
Well, it's a rush of blood to the head. He's seen the ball, he's gone for it, and he's just mistimed the tackle horribly.
Bertrand. And he's dispossessed. There's Joe Aguero.
He's got space. Here's the chance.
That's taking advantage of the extra man, isn't it, to get a goal like that?
Well, not always easy. You don't always see teams take advantage of the extra man, but this lot have, and that's wonderful. Wonderful technique to just feather it into the bottom line.
It's Manchester City's match.
Ladies and gentlemen, for your own safety and security...
You don't often get such a one-sided match at this level of the game, but that's what we've seen, Alan.
Well, we have, and credit to the players out there for playing so well and for dominating it right from start to finish.
Well, there was only one team in that game, and the home fans will be going home delighted with their big win. Today, it's Newcastle United against West Ham United. Let's head straight for St. James's Park, the home of Newcastle United, and I'm delighted to say the North East is bathed in sunshine today.
He's coming forward with some danger.
Great chance, got to be. Tremendous work from Tim Krul.
West Ham United have given a corner here. Downing.
In with a chance. And that's a fantastic goal.
Well, no sooner has the referee given the goal he's going to blow for half-time. They've scored just before the whistle.
Yeah, that's changed the manager's team talk. Both managers.
Another angle on it here. That's a very crisp challenge there. Sizoka. Jonas Gutierrez.
Played into the middle. Sizoko. Brilliant opening, got to be.
I don't think he was quite sure where the goal was as he took the shot on. Musa Sizoko.
across. We have it back.
Oh, he's got past his man here.
Downing. And back it goes. Downing. Goes for goal! A decent effort. Just off top. Going on Anita. Oh, he's missed the target. Well, it kept rising and always going over the bar.
It would have been a worldie, that, and he's capable of it, but not today.
He might be through. Here's the chance. Off target. Referee blows, and there's the win for West Ham United.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm sure you'll agree it's been a cracking game of football. Now let's all enjoy
that is
it
a win to cherish today.
Oh, most definitely. Although they made one or two mistakes at the back, the strikers were good enough to win the spoils.
So it's full time with the final score. It's Stoke City against Liverpool. Let's go straight to the Britannia Stadium. A beautiful day at the home of Stoke City. Glorious, clear blue skies.
Tony Pulis leaving benefited both Stoke and Crystal Palace because perhaps he'd served his time there and the stage had been reached where a new manager take the team on and a slightly different style of...
Dangerous moment, in with a chance, and that's a fantastic goal.
A goal from Henderson, and that's what you call unstoppable. Hit with power, hit into the bottom right-hand corner.
And here's the cross. Lambert! And the header is into the net. He's headed that beautifully. It's a real example of how to score with your head. Charlie Adam. Here is a chance for them. Got to be. A surprise for him, Alan. He's normally ruthless in front of goal.
Well, he is only human, I suppose. It was a mistimed shot, and in the end, he can afford to laugh at it.
Here's Gerrard. Johnson. Coutinho. Goes for goal! Off the crossbar. And back into the penalty area. Here's the shot. Great opportunity for a great player, but not a great finish. Johnson. Steven Gerrard. It's bounced back off the bar. Possibilities for Liverpool. In with a chance. Not a and he goes for goal. Hit the post. Gerrard almost grazing the top of the crossbar. Good, strong challenge. Got to be. Gerrard!
Oh, all credit to them for keeping going. They've widened the margin here and enjoying themselves.
Yeah, why not? Every coach wants to see his team keep their feet on the accelerator, as it were, and this team has. Well, by a country mile, they have been the better team out here, and the scoreline has reflected that. Game over.
Now called a halt.
Ladies and gentlemen, for your own safety and security.
Well, one team's coming off looking pretty fresh, the other team exhausted. They've been chasing the game, haven't they, the whole time?
Yeah, they have, and a game they haven't enjoyed, and they just want to hear the final whistle.
Today, it's Chelsea against Sunderland. Let's go straight off to Stamford Bridge, and I'm delighted to say it's a lovely, clear day in West London.
They've got the ball back through a very good interception. He's coming forward with some danger. Great chance. Got to be. Won by the goalkeeper. Just thinking of Chelsea in that 2013-14 season when Mourinho came back. They did a double over the champions, Manchester City, double over the team at the second, Liverpool, galling only to finish third.
Well, I think that would be the case, and that's an example of Jose Mourinho setting up his side perfectly to do the job against specific opponents, and there's not many better. It's against the bottom half teams that they had some problems, didn't they? So that's in an area they need to address.
What a chance here, got to be, and Chelsea put it into the net.
And that's blown past the keeper before really he could react.
Different angle on it here. Here's Fabregas. And it's a decision made by Craig Pawson. Well, he's away from his marker now. In with a chance. Still in play here. And that cross is won by the defender. Well blocked. Buckley.
Just sums up his form. He's really been in a shocking spell when he can't do anything right.
That is the final whistle. You've enjoyed the game as much as we have up on the commentary gantry, and the winning team will be enjoying it, because a win's one thing, but to win playing that well, certainly in the attacking sense, that's almost the whole package, isn't it?
Yeah, he swarmed forward and the opposition didn't know where to look. The movement, the work rate, and then the finishing, you couldn't fault it.